thanks for coming to my little breakdown. It's kind of like a little behind the scenes, a little case study of my work in Mitchell's versus the Machines. I do animation and design called FUI Design. It stands for Futuristic, Fictional, Fantasy, Fake, Fancy, Film, User Interfaces. So today is about Mitchell's versus the Machines. So there was a lot to contribute to as far as technology in the film. And the first one is the Orchestra UI. This is kind of where the robots kind of sit and take over the world, right? So I'll walk you through this process. So starting with a sketch, I always tell myself, look, free yourself to draw badly at first. It beats starting with a blank page. So then after that, after scribbling, I'll go into like Procreate and start sketching a little bit more detail and everything. And instead of lines, I started kind of like experimenting with gradients to kind of be the shape language. It's more like a texture than a line work to define the UI, which I've never really seen done before. All this was done in Illustrator. It's all vector, so even the little glints are actually just circles with gradients. So you can get a lot from just Illustrator. And by doing it this way, I could kind of control all the lighting and the luminance and how it worked and put it just directly onto 3D models. And it made for a really fast, real-time kind of workflow. The language that you might notice in there, that was the other big part that we had to kind of figure out. It started like this. And what we decided was, we'll put this on the side for now. Let's explore geometrics, because it's looking a little busy. And this film is simple. I wanted to not do hexagons because it's so done, so I started focusing again on these triangles. I did like that idea, man. The other thing I explored was like, maybe there's triangular grids inside of a triangle, then what shapes could come out of that? But I also just wanted to explore other things, like making these triangles into squares, basically. Originally, it all was fitting in a square, which was pretty limiting. It's looking a little boxy and everything. So what I did was I took my grid and I offset it, and that allowed me to do a lot of different shapes on top of that. That, as a language, you want this all to be consistent, right? I also wanted these letter forms to have a personality. Doing it in a grid like this actually is very freeing. It allows you to animate them really fast, like a number roll up or anything, and they're not going to be all over the place. It's going to look really consistent. Or you could use it as wallpaper, like for around the world. And that's actually what they ended up doing. They used it pretty much on a ton of the sets in the robot world. And then the last thing I want to take you through is HUDs. These are used throughout the film as the robot's point of view when they're tracking the Mitchells and trying to find them and eventually get them and capture them. So one sequence in particular is the pig-dog sequence. But essentially, the robots are trying to figure out what the family pet is, and they just can't make it out. And so I knew I wanted to do like a face scan for the dog. So what I kind of came up with was this idea of like it trying to make out the lo-fi triangular dimensions of his face, and that it would kind of animate on like origami. And then I also wanted to show the processing of the computer. Also, the little callouts, you know, we'd made them look kind of pretty different, but the idea was that the computer would be flipping through stock imagery. And so Toby Wilson did these paintings of the pig and the dog. And then I kind of had this idea of it being very indecisive. The last shot is just kind of like a targeting shot. So I immediately jump into C4D, just start what could be a cool scanning thing with triangles and stuff. And for the crosshair, rather than just like a typical crosshair type of thing, I just wanted to do something pretty different. And it ended up being this guy right here, which was pretty cool because I could pull it out, bring it back in. You can see even my scannings have little triangles and stuff. That's kind of the process, the simple process of doing this and arriving at, you know, something that ends up in the film. If you can visually communicate like your thought process, your inner thought process, it goes a long way. On all my work, I have a reason for everything. Working on the film with Sony reminded me of some things I think we all need to be reminded of. You know, allow yourself the joy of trying and striving to make something great and unique and different. It's exactly those little details that nobody's going to notice that maybe one day people are going to notice, and it's going to set you apart. So always remember to play, have fun with your work, and I appreciate you guys being here. It was a joy to show this to you. So 80% of my work is actually done on a little MacBook Air. So what that allows is the technology just kind of disappears, and I love just being able to go to the park or a coffee shop and be able to jam out and get creative. So this was great fun hanging out with all the Adobe employees and presenting, and I will see you next year.